As you can see here, I've got a bigger saw and I'm just blocking it out. That's a piece of black walnut that I'm working with, and I've screwed it down to the bench so that it's solid and safe and everything. And I've got it on high speed because, other words, I'll be cutting all day on here and run out of video. So I've got an image in my mind. I've looked at a couple of pictures, and I don't usually draw a lot of lines and stuff unless it's something that I'm really worried about being dead on proportion and everything. And I'll just carry on from there, and you guys can kind of watch the process. So when I the video previous,
I started with a bigger saw. That's a 50cc saw, the 18-inch bar. Basically, it was the blocking process. So I don't draw a whole lot of lines and stuff. I visualize what I want to do in my head. And this is going to be basically a seagull sitting on a post. Okay? It's going to be added to another carving. So I like to use a little bigger saw. It's not too big, okay? You can still handle it safely, as you see in the video and everything. Bigger saw with a smaller tip bar and a smaller chain. Kickback is, there's still some kickback, but it's almost zero. I'm gonna now switch to a little carving saw. This is 30cc, 193, with a little 9-inch carving bar on it. These carving bars, there's no sprocket tip in them like these bars have. Okay, so you got to run the chain loose, as you can see. On a standard tip bar, you're running the chain so it's taut. Okay, still spins free, but it's got a sprocket on the tip, so it has to be fairly taut to be keep it on the bar safely and everything else. So the process, just basically take your shape. I'm using kind of the profiles, looking at it from this view, and took all this stuff off, and now I've been going around it and making the posts and everything. And I could do a little bit more with this saw, but I'll switch to the carving saw to give you a little bit of demo on that.